الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد. My dear and most respected brothers and sisters and friends, I greet you all with the greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this special program coming to you from the Islamic Forum of Canada, where we share with you this message of mercy from God Almighty to all of His creation. We are now in this special sacred month of Dhul-Qa'dah, and I want to share with you an incident which took place in the sixth year after the Hijrah in this month of Dhul-Qa'dah, and it is the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this month of Dhul-Qa'dah, he left Medina with thousands of Sahabas to go to Mecca to perform Umrah. And he approached Mecca, and on the outskirts of Mecca, he stopped at a place called Hudaybiyah. And then he sent representatives to the Quraysh in Mecca to get their permission to enter Mecca, to visit the Kaaba, to perform Umrah. But the Quraysh refused. There were lengthy negotiations between the two parties. The Quraysh refused, and then they signed a treaty, and the Quraysh, the people of Mecca, stipulated conditions for that treaty, and saying that they would allow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahabas, his companions, to come the following year to perform Umrah. And the conditions that were there, that were imposed by the Quraysh, were unfavorable to the Muslims. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepted their conditions. For example, the Quraysh demanded that if anyone from their ranks, from Mecca, the people of Mecca, the Quraysh of Mecca, if they were to accept Islam and go to Medina, the Prophet Muhammad would not accept them in Medina. He could not do that. But if anyone from Medina, the Muslims, if they changed their religion and came to the Quraysh in Mecca, they would be allowed to accept them. So unfavorable conditions of the treaty. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the guidance he received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accepted these conditions, signed that treaty. And then when he was returning to Medina from Hudaybiyah, and the Sahabas were disappointed that they did not get to perform Umrah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this beautiful ayah in Surah Al-Fath, "Inna fatahna laka fathan mubinan." Verily, we have granted you the greatest of victories, even though on the outside it would seem as if it was a defeat for the Muslims because of the conditions they agreed to in this Treaty of Hudaybiyah. But subsequent events would show that indeed it was a great victory for the Muslims, because it led the way for the Fath of Mecca, In 2 years after that, this greatest of victory that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to here, inna fatahna laka fathan mubinan. So this important event of Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, or the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, took place in this month of Dhul-Qa'dah that we're in right now, in the sixth year of the Hijrah. And I wanted to start off the program today by referring to this important event, this important incident, because there are many great lessons to be learned from this, most important of which is obedience to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the incident that took place at Hudaybiyah after the signing of the treaty with Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, when he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he questioned the Prophet, why you accepted this condition, why you accepted that condition and so on, we are willing to fight to defend Islam, defend you. The Prophet alaihi salatu wasallam mentioned him finally in that conversation, Alastu bi Rasulillah, am I not the messenger of Allah? Am I not the Prophet of Allah? And Sayyidina Umar understood that he had overstepped his bounds, that he should not have questioned the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the lesson is obedience to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in all situations, in all conditions. For us now, his injunctions, his orders, his sunnah, the laws that he established, the stipulations he made, we are obligated to follow that and to obey him and to love him as much as we can. So the Treaty of Hudaybiyah established this important principle. And then also to understand that sometimes in our lives, we may be faced with difficult conditions, difficult situations. But once we turn to Allah, once we hold on to Allah, once we remain firm in faith with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with God Almighty, then He takes care of us, as He did with the Sahabas there at Hudaybiyah. They were disappointed. Imagine, they left Medina in Ihram with a niyyah to perform Hajj, and here they are at Hudaybiyah, just on the outskirts of Mecca, so close, and they're not able to enter Mecca. They're turned back empty-handed. They have to take off the Ihram and so on. And in fact, when the Prophet told them to shave their heads, take off the ihram, come out of the state of ihram, that they return back to Medina, not being able to perform Umrah at that time because of the conditions of Quraysh and what they stipulated, they were hesitant. They didn't want to do that. And then Sayyidina Aisha, the beloved wife of the Prophet, she came to him and she told him, Ya Rasulullah. And he was concerned about them not listening to him. And she told him, it's not that they're disobeying you. It's just that they're so sad, the Sahabas, that they're not able to perform Umrah and they have to return to Medina. And then she suggested to him, why don't you go out? And they were camped in tents at Hudaybiyah. Why don't you go out in the middle of this camp and have your head shaved? And he did that. And as he started to shave his head, the Sahabas came out weeping, crying, and shaved their head to come out of the city of Ihram and return back to Medina. Difficult situation, yes, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared it as the greatest of victory. Inna fatahna laka fathan mubinan. And this is in the sixth year of the Hijrah. In the eighth year of the Hijrah, just 2 years after that, the Muslims rode into Mecca, conquered Mecca in the greatest of victories, in this bloodless conquest of Mecca, and the people of Mecca all accepted Islam, and Mecca became that city of Islam and of Muslims, the home of the Kaaba and the home of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A great event indeed, and a great lesson for us. I must also today remind you of the great time we are in now, on the threshold of the great days of mercy, the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sacred days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love good deeds to be performed in these times more than in any other time in the year. مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ, in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran, وَالْفَجْر وَلَيَالٍ عَشْر, referring to these special days that are coming up, starting Tuesday night, the first night night of Dhul Hijjah and the 10 great days that are coming for us to perform great deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we suggest, the dhikr project, I mentioned before, please remember this, istighfar, salawat, tahleel. Istighfar to recite astaghfirullah, salawat to recite the salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and tahleel to recite la ilaha illallah. And then the Quran project, remember that, one ayah per day to read, study, memorize, one ayah per day. I want you to commit yourself to doing this. Start with 5 minutes a day, but every day. And then ramp that up, increase that to 10 minutes a day, to 15 minutes a day, to 20 minutes a day, in that gradual sequence to maintain your daily relationship with this Quran. One ayah a day, read, study, memorize. And subhanAllah, if you had joined the project when we started it, you would memorize much of the Quran already. I want you to start that today. Commit yourself to this Quran project, one ayah a day, and in a short period of time, by the end of this year, you'll be surprised how much you've memorized of the Quran, how much you know of the Quran because of this daily relationship with the Quran. And thirdly, the infaq project, spending in way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And later on in our program today, I would share with you the great opportunity to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this special sacred time that we're in, Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah, starting Tuesday night, and the special days of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in these special times. Ameen.
At the Islamic Forum School, we teach Islamic sciences, Arabic language, and tajweed training. Classes are available for all age groups. It was narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "A faithful person cannot have enough of teachings that lead to piety, guidance, until it leads him to paradise." It was also narrated, "Scholars are the inheritors of the sciences of the prophets of Allah." It was also narrated, "Words of wisdom are the beloved of the faithful." It was narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked why he fasts Mondays. He said, "It was the day I was born." As was narrated in Hadith Qudsi, "Those whom are engaged in my mentioning, I am with them, as if I was their companion." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, "Those who mention Allah profusely are given by Allah forgiveness and great reward."
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. We have started registration for the new Islamic school year in September. You can contact Islamic Forum and register your children for the Islamic school program at the Islamic Forum. Also, this is a Saturday Islamic school. Also, we have the full-time school for junior kindergarten and senior kindergarten. If you would like to register your children for the full-time Islamic school at the Islamic Forum, please contact us for further details and to register your children. The Mawlid family program continues this evening, 6 p.m. at the Islamic Forum. And every Saturday at 6 p.m., please bring your family, come out and join us at the Islamic Forum for this special spiritual evening every Saturday at 6 p.m. at Islamic Forum. Friday, Jum'ah, 1 p.m. Every Friday throughout the year. We hope to see you next Friday at the Islamic Forum for Jum'ah, and please tell your relatives and friends to come out as well. Earlier this week was a special day for Pakistan and for the Muslim Ummah, the Independence Day. August the 14th, we make special dua for the country. We extend special congratulations to the Honorable Consul General of the Consulate in Toronto, the Honorable Ambassador in Ottawa, for the Pakistani Embassy, and for the government and people of Pakistan, praying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Pakistan with peace and security, safety and happiness, and bless the Ummah with peace and security as well. Tomorrow is a special day for me and my family, August the 20th. It is my birthday, and I want to kindly request you to recite Surah Yasin if possible and make dua for me and my family. I want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his blessings and his bounties, praying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accept all the good that we have done and help us to do more to serve his cause, to serve the Ummah, to serve the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to spread this mahabbah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is our mission. This is what we are committed to spreading the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the mahabbah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his blessings, and we pray for his Kabul, that he accept all we've done, and for him to grant us ziyadah to help us to do more to serve the Muslims. I want to thank everyone for their support for these many, many years of doing Islamic work, and we appreciate your support, and we request you today for your dua on this occasion of my birthday tomorrow, August the 20th, inshallah. This past week was a sad occasion for the Islamic Forum. One of the stalwarts of the Islamic Forum, one of the leading members of our congregation, our dear brother Sayyid Imtiaz Anwar, who fell sick in Ramadan and his condition worsened. He passed away, and we say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, and we did his janazah and burial, and we make special dua for him. And I want to request each one of you to make special dua for Brother Sayyid Imtiaz Anwar. He was a wonderful person, a great Muslim, a loyal supporter of the Islamic Forum. Every Friday he was there at Jum'ah and at special occasions, and whenever he had a time, he was a host of several radio programs for many years, always trying to do something good and worthwhile for the Muslim community. We convey our condolences to his family, his wife and two daughters, and the rest of his family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them with sabr and istiqamah, and bless our dear brother Sayyid Imtiaz Anwar with peace and security and happiness in the hereafter. Grant him forgiveness, grant him mercy, and grant him dukhul al-jannah, grant him the highest levels of jannatul firdaus, the paradise. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Eid al-Adha is coming up soon. The first of Dhul Hijjah is next Wednesday, August the 23rd. So Tuesday night, August 22nd, would be the first night of Dhul Hijjah. And so the special time start. So next Tuesday, please remember that to start. There will be nightly Mawlid at Islamic Forum and special programs throughout the month of Dhul Hijjah. This is a great sacred month of Hajj. On the night of Dhul Hijjah, Thursday, August the 31st, this is a day of Arafat. And so Thursday evening, we'll have special iftar program at the Islamic Forum for this great day of Arafat. It's the greatest day of the year. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says about the fasting on the day of Arafat, yukafir sanat al-madiya wal-baqiya. It is forgiveness for sins of the preceding year and the following year. So 2 years of forgiveness for 1 day of fasting. 2 years of blessing for 1 day of fasting, the day of Arafat. So I want to encourage all of you to fast. In fact, you should start fasting from the first of Dhul Hijjah, from now, next Wednesday, and for the 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. Until the ninth, the pinnacle of the fast of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Arafat. And then the 10th of Dhul Hijjah is Friday, the 4th of September, and this is the day of Eid al-Adha. So we invite you to come out to the Islamic Forum for Eid on Friday, September the 1st. Please contact the Islamic Forum the day before to confirm, or actually anytime after the 4th of Dhul Hijjah, next Wednesday, to confirm Eid. The timing of Eid Salah, 8 a.m., the first Salah, this is the main Salah, inshallah, I will be leading that Salah, and then 10 a.m. and 11 a.m., three Salah of Eid al-Adha we have at the Islamic Forum. We invite you to come out, and please bring your relatives and friends to come with you as well. I want to take this opportunity to thank all those who contributed to our successful summer camp for this year, especially Sayyida Leem and Sayyida Maryam and Sayyida Fatima for the great work they did, and the team of volunteers and counselors, the supporters and donors and sponsors, and of course the children who attended our summer camp for this year. We have a special appeal today for our new masjid project. Remember, we had appealed for the four upper walls of the masjid. Alhamdulillah, with your support and the support of many brothers and sisters, we were able to complete that. So we've completed the four upper walls of the masjid. And now the next phase of our construction is the ceiling, the roof of the masjid. We need to raise $200,000. We make this special appeal to you today. And we've divided it into blocks of $100. We want you to sponsor one block for $100, inshallah. If you can afford more than one block, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, the blessings are great from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a special appeal today, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften your hearts and bless you to respond positively to this appeal. You can contact this line form, call us, and let us know how much you would like to donate for this special appeal for the roof, the ceiling of the masjid project. Or you can go online, islamforumonline.com, to the donation page and make your donation there, inshallah. Recently, I was invited to visit Malaysia for a lecture tour. I've been there before, and it was a wonderful opportunity for me to visit Malaysia again. It's a beautiful country, beautiful people, amazing adab, and I've mentioned that in this program before. That entire area, Malaysia, Indonesia, the entire Malay Peninsula, beautiful countries, beautiful people with adab, with Islam in their lives, very hospitable, and I thank all of them, all the organizers who hosted me, for their kindness and generosity. One of the things I want to share with you today, it's a special award I received on this recent visit to Malaysia. I was invited to deliver the keynote address at an international Islamic conference, and there, part of the program, we were hosted by the former Prime Minister of Malaysia, His Excellency Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad. He is the fourth Prime Minister of Malaysia and the longest serving Prime Minister of Malaysia. He served Malaysia as Prime Minister for 22 years, and he is considered the father of modern Malaysia. He took that country from a poor third world country to being one of the more developed Muslim countries in the world. Amazing progress that he introduced, and it was an honor to be invited by him and to be hosted by him for a special program. And this was to honor global Islamic personality and to give special awards to a select group of scholars. And I was honored to receive the most prominent scholar of Tasawwuf award, the most prominent scholar of Tasawwuf, Tasawwuf meaning Islamic spirituality. And I received that special award from His Excellency Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad, the former Prime Minister of Malaysia. It was a great honor indeed, and I wanted to share this good news with you today. And first and foremost, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to thank all of those that have contributed to me reaching this amazing award, to receive this award from such a great Islamic personality as His Excellency Dr. Mahathir Mohamad, the former Prime Minister of Malaysia, who is respected throughout the Muslim world as one of the more important Islamic personalities today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him, bless his family, bless the people of Malaysia, bless the country, and with more progress, and to be a good example for Muslims throughout the world and for all of humanity for their goodness that they share. Ameen, ameen, ameen.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, O you who believe, when you hear the call to Jumu'ah, hasten to make the mentioning of Allah. It was narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Friday is the best of days that the sun has risen on. And he also said, there is an hour on the day of Jumu'ah, or Jumu'ah, during which the prayer of a Muslim is answered.
وعلمت أني حين تشقيني الدنا لا أرتجي في كربتي.
It was narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "A hajj that is accepted by Allah cannot be rewarded with less than paradise." It was also narrated, "Those who visit me in my grave and make salam to me, Allah will return my soul to me so that I can return their salam." It was also narrated, "He who makes hajj, enduring which does not transgress in word or action, will be forgiven his sins, to become sinless like a newborn."
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us this great opportunity for us to do good deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these times when good deeds are more loved by Allah than in any other time. The Prophet said, "Man bana lillahi masjidan bana Allahu lahu baytan fil jannah." That if you build a masjid for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build for you a beautiful mansion, a home in paradise, in Jannah. In another version of the hadith, it says, "Man bana لِلَّهِ مَسْجِدًا بَنَى اللَّهُ لَهُ بَيْتًا مِثْلَهُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ." That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build for you a similar home in Jannah for the masjid you build in this world. So I want to encourage you to use this opportunity to contribute to the new masjid project, the appeal we're making for the ceiling, the roof of the masjid. We need to raise $200,000. We've divided that into small shares of $100 to sponsor one block. We hope you can sponsor a block today. You can go to the Islam Forum website, or you can call us, contact us, so we can, one of the volunteers can facilitate your donation. Please tell your relatives and friends to donate to the Islamic Forum as well. And we hope that you can respond positively to this appeal today. Until we meet again next week, same time, same place, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you. Remember to prepare for Eid al-Adha. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله صلوا عليه وآله بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله.